Stubby the Teaching Hexapod has come a long way in the past couple of months. What started off existence as essentially a toy has progressed into an open source, extensible robotics platform and teaching tool. My work for the Hackaday Prize is to enable the control of Stubby using a computer over Bluetooth. Along with this, I am writing a processing library to simplify operations so that young children or non-programmers can learn the basics of programming. This library will still retain enough functionality so that more experienced programmers can have the power needed to control complex behavior and even autonomous operation. This work is progressing nicely. I have refactored the robot's firmware to support multiple controller modes. In the processing control mode, there is a message dispatch function called from a serial interrupt to process incoming commands. A set of command executor functions are constantly running to actually perform the commands. Communication is bidirectional, with Stubby acknowledging each incoming command, as well as indicating when certain commands, such as movement commands, which may take some time, are completed. Princess Sparkle, my 6-year-old daughter and Hackaday Prize team member, has already written a simple program which commands Stubby to walk along a course.
Hi, I'm Princess Sparkle from the Stubby team, and I am going to explain how I did this program. Step 1, I learned to measure distances. Step 2, with my dad's help, we drew a small and simple course for Stubby to follow. Step 3, I measured the distances in between each turn. Step 4, I wrote a program to tell Stubby how far to go and where to turn. Now I will explain my program. The computer knows it's talking to Stubby. And then this is Stubby. Dot turn on. That's just Stubby. You have to write Stubby first, or else it doesn't know what you're talking to. It's like, ooh, what is it doing? Who is this? What is happening? And so, then, says Stubby, move forward 88 millimeters. Stubby, turn right. Stubby, move forward 40 millimeters. Stubby, turn right. Stubby, move forward 44 millimeters. Stubby, turn left. Stubby, move forward 126 millimeters. Stubby, turn off.
In addition to programming skills, she is also learning how to measure distances on a ruler, how to convert from centimeters to millimeters, how to perform multi-digit addition, how to plan a simple route, and of course, how to use computers. Future teaching exercises include instructing Stubby to navigate a course with more waypoints and non-90-degree angles. Eventually, we will work up to reading sensors into variables, using conditional logic, and making course decisions on the fly. There is still a lot of work to do. One bug which Princess Sparkle and I noticed while programming the distance course is that Stubby tends to veer while walking, and when turning, does not always turn to the exact desired angle. This is not an issue when using the universal controller, as you can easily adjust to compensate, but when programming a course with no feedback loop, it presents a major obstacle. I am currently researching methods to overcome this problem. To date, the best answer looks to be the addition of a magnetometer to detect the current bearing, along with a PID routine to adjust rotation on the fly. As for outstanding functionality, I have not yet implemented any of the more advanced commands, such as body rotation, translation, etc. I have plans for adding sensors, and I'm waiting on a new set of circuit boards which will allow this. Once the boards arrive, Stubby will be able to detect distance using a tiltable ultrasonic rangefinder, will be able to detect compass directions using a magnetometer, and will be able to see light and dark using an array of infrared LEDs on the bottom. An I2C breakout will allow for third parties to add additional sensors without needing a board redesign.
Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed our video.